What genre are you working with?
So what we're doing is we're creating a 30 for 30 on the WNBA, and we're promoting WNBA.
What conventions are you trying to challenge and why?
You know, many people say the WNBA is unathletic and it's not very competitive. Many people also sexualize the WNBA and bring up the fact that it's summer fun, whereas regular basketball is played in the winter.
How does your work relate to themes of the course?
So there's three major themes of the course that our work relates to. The first is watching. Right off the bat, less people watch the WNBA than most other professional sports and college sports. And also, people watching the WNBA are more likely to have a bad encounter rather than a good encounter for many reasons, possibly because of advertisements on jerseys can turn fans away. Turning on an event and seeing empty stands, you're going to be less likely to watch that event. And then also just low scores and kind of the negative stigmas that we've talked about. We're also talking about the market. What we talk about in market is kind of active participation versus passive consumption. With many big-time sports in America, you see more of this active participation by fans. The fandom is much higher and much more intense, where with the WNBA, it's very passively watched. You don't really hear of anybody talking about they're a huge fan of the Tulsa Shock or any WNBA team. I couldn't even name, can't really even name any WNBA teams. Also, you don't have any media analysts who just talk about the WNBA. It's very much so on the back burners. And then finally, constraints, just simple rule differences between the WNBA and the NBA, such as a smaller ball, the three-point line is shorter, and then there's also less teams and less games played throughout the regular season.
What difficulties did you encounter, and how did you overcome them?
So we did not want to discredit the skill of the WNBA players. We also wanted to reverse some negative connotations that a lot of people might have with the WNBA. And we did this by putting clips of highlights and highlighting a lot of the skills that these women have.
What if I told you a film could change the way you look at sports? ESPN Films presents The Return of 30 for 30.
I look at the stars of the NBA, and you got guys like Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan, Shaquille O'Neal. They knew how to play the game of basketball, and I see the same from a girl named Skylar Diggins. She needs to be known globally. You're gonna have people wearing her jerseys. I don't care if they have advertisements on them, I'm telling you now. I've been around the game for 30 years. When you watch her play, her shot, her ability, her demeanor, it needs to be recognized. She's a star in the making in a league that needs them.
Let me talk about the forgotten bad girl of the WNBA, because that's what she was in college when she played at Baylor University. 6'9". We all know her. We all love her. Brittany Griner scored 50 points against Kansas State in a game. She averaged 3-4 blocks for the entire season. Unheard of statistics for a girl, let alone any player I've ever seen on a basketball court. And now where is she? I'm not particularly sure, because the WNBA is so obscure. But let me say something. Every time I watch these girls on the TV, they are mean. They are aggressive. They want to win those basketball games. It's a beautiful thing to watch, let me tell you that. And me, myself, I want to see more. I want to see more.